In the spring of 2008, my wife Cynthia and I visited Cooley-related sites in Ireland and England. We spent a week here in Dublin, enjoying this thriving city and its many pubs. One of the reasons I wanted to go to Ireland was to explore the Cooley Peninsula, which is about 50 miles north of Dublin. The peninsula is very famous because this is where the classic Irish myth, the cattle raid of Cooley, took place. To get there, we had a friend drive us up from Dublin. It took about 1 hour to drive to the Cooley Peninsula. Here's a close-up of the peninsula. In the lower right, you can see where Cooley Point is located. It is also a fishing hotspot, as you can see here. Now learned men who use the pen who wrote your praises high, this sweet poutine from Ireland. Cooley Point juts out into the Irish Sea. Our summer home in New Hampshire is named Cooley Point, so seeing the Irish version was a grand experience. We were pleased to see how clean they kept the beach at Cooley Point. And here is why. We visited the Cooley Distillery, tasted some great Irish whiskey, and learned that the founder and owner was a Harvard graduate who named his firm after the Cooley Peninsula, a place name, not a family name. That is also true of the Cooley Inn, which is on the outskirts of the beautiful fishing village of Carlingford, the main port town on the north shore of the Cooley Peninsula. Here at the Heritage Center, a guide assures us that there are no Cooley families in this part of Ireland. But the beautiful Cooley Mountains can be seen all over town. This is the highest point in the peninsula's mountain range. The trail of the cattle raid comes down through these mountains. Here at the dock, the King John's Castle is a prominent ruin on the shore in Carlingford. Back in Dublin, we came upon this colorful ceramic mural of the famous cattle raid of Cooley. Here you see the two bulls fighting it out on the Cooley Peninsula. This is the Dublin City Hall, a beautiful neoclassical building designed by Thomas Cooley. Checking his biography, I discovered that he was a London architect who moved to Dublin in 1775. He designed many of Dublin's famous buildings. Looking in the vast National Library in Dublin for his origins, I learned that Thomas Cooley was born in England of unknown parents. Here at Trinity College, I met with experts in genetic genealogy. They were fascinated with the summary of Cooley DNA results, which Greg Parker has established for the Cooley Family Association, and the stability of the DNA profile for the descendants of Benjamin Cooley, regardless of which of the four sons of Benjamin we each represented, 11 or more generations later. While in London, we took a short train ride north to Tring, the probable birthplace of Benjamin Cooley in 1615. Tring is filled with charming English Tudor-style buildings. The Tring Parish Church is in the Diocese of St. Albans, which explains the references to St. Albans in the Cooley family history. It was a real thrill to walk around the ancient grounds of the church, filled with tombstones. Their parish records go back to 1566. They indicate that Benjamin Cooley was baptized here in 1616, the son of William Cooley and Joan Arnott. They had at least two other sons besides Benjamin. Since there are Tring parish records regarding the subsequent activities of those brothers, it is very possible that some of their descendants remained in the Tring area. It would be very exciting to obtain DNA profiles of some of those Tring Cooleys and compare them to our Cooley family DNA profile. Trinity College Dublin has been a leader in such surname DNA studies. Hopefully we can do such a study for the Cooley surname.